Come cook with me. I'm Smita. Good to see you all. We haven't seen each other in a while. Today we are going to make mogo. Mogo is a Swahili word for yuka or cassava. Because I grew up in Uganda, we call it mogo. So to make it easy, you can buy frozen mogo. This is what it looks like in the store. So I took 7 or 8 pieces of frozen mogo and boiled it with salt until it was soft. You can drain the water and let the mogo cool down. I'm using sunflower oil to deep fry the mogo. We don't need too much oil, just enough to deep fry it. We are going to turn the stove on now and put it on high so the oil heats up. This mogo is cool enough to cut into thin strips now. If it's too hot, then you can't cut it properly. That's why you have to cool it down. So if you cut them in thin strips, they will be very crispy. And if you cut them in thicker ones, it will be soft. So whatever your preference. You might find some strings in this mogo. Just make sure that you pull them out, because you can't fry these strings and eat them. They'll get stuck in your throat. Make sure the oil is hot. If you put cold mogo in not enough hot oil, it will cool down the oil more and it will not fry properly. If it floats right away, the oil is hot enough. No, wait a couple of more minutes. Make sure you do it very gently. You don't want to burn your fingers. You can also eat this mogo boiled. You don't have to fry it. It does taste good. You can season it with chili pepper, a little bit more salt, and lime. When the bottom side of the mogo is ready, it will float up. And then you flip the mogo. This mogo was air fried. I cut it in strips, brushed it with a little bit of oil, and just put it in the air fryer. In the air fryer, it took about 5 to 7 minutes at 350 degrees temperature. Not ready yet. We have to be a little patient. So while we are waiting for that, I'm also cutting up the rest of the mogo to make it in a little different way. We are going to flip the mogo and make sure it fries on both sides. I promise you, you can't go wrong with this mogo. Easiest thing you can make. Takes about 5-7 minutes to fry it on a proper stove. Because it's a hot plate, it's taking a little longer. There, it's ready. Does look good. So while it's hot, sprinkle a little bit of salt. Remember, we also put salt in boiling it. So just a little bit of salt and red pepper, or chili pepper, or cayenne, as much or as little as you like. And you can also squeeze some lime before you eat. For this version of mogo, we need mustard seeds, turmeric, chopped green chilies, and chopped coriander. And we also need 2 teaspoons of oil. We need a pot. Pour 2 teaspoons of oil in there and let it heat up. I'm going to add the turmeric on the mogo here. I just find it easier. There, don't need too much at all. And I'm also going to put the coriander on here. Okay. Feels like the oil is hot enough. I'm going to put some mustard seeds. Don't put too much, otherwise it will be too bitter. Just a few more. It starts crackling. Here. You want to make sure they all pop, otherwise they'll be bitter. It's coming along. There. Can you hear? Popping. You can also see them popping. Don't go too close to the pot, otherwise the mustard seeds will hurt your eyes. You can also smell it now. And then you're going to add your green chilies. Let it cook for even like only 30 seconds and add your mogo. You can turn the heat a little low. And let it cook for about 2-3 minutes. Looks good. Stay far, otherwise it will mess up your clothes too.
Fine.
Nice clothes. Yep, ready. Turn it off. The other way. I did it wrong. If you like to have it red, then don't add the green chilies, add red cayenne pepper to it. And it will be red in color. But I think this looks really good. You can eat mogo as a snack. It's really filling. Shetu doesn't want to be on the video, but she's behind the camera, but and she's going to try it and tell you how it tastes.
Okay. How did you get like this? Oh, it's really good.
How good is it?
It's delicious.
Okay. Don't use that word.
What else do you want? Word do you want me to use?
It says it tastes like my cooking.
It tastes like your cooking.
If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you.